I'm Hazel, and today I've got some tips for making and keeping your gold in Classic WoW. You'll need between 64 and 80 gold for your first mount at level 40, and a lot more than that for your epic mount at 60. All that's not about to happen by accident, so I rounded up some advice. Tip 1, loot and sell everything. Since this is an age before mission tables and world quests, a lot of the gold entering the game is from vendoring item drops. Gray items, white gear, weird greens with bizarre stats that nobody wants, the vendor will take it all. Of course, your bags are going to limit how much you can carry around, so get in the habit of sniffing out vendors and going back to them often. Also, don't forget that AoE looting is not a thing in Classic, so you gotta loot each mob individually. Tip 2, make a bank alt. Vendoring's great, but lots of things will sell on the auction house, and nobody's got time to stop questing and run all the way back there. Make a level 1 character, run them to an auction house, and you've got yourself some extra storage and easy posting. Anything that you think might sell, mail it to your bank alt and try. Now, there is a 1 hour delay on all mail arriving, even when you send it to yourself. Even so, it's still faster than dragging yourself all the way back to an auction house on your teeny tiny little feet. I do advise you though to be careful and keep an eye on the vendor price of whatever you're selling so you know when to give up and just vendor it. I use an add-on called Vendor Prices to show me those in the tooltips even if I'm not at a vendor. It's very handy. While on the topic of the Vendor Prices add-on, the other thing that it can do is show you the lowest value item in your bags. Ideally, you make it back to a vendor before your bags fill, but sometimes life happens. Hold down left control while this add-on is installed, and vendor prices will show you the trashiest trash to delete so you can pick up your slightly less trashy trash. Tip 4, do not train every skill at your trainer. New options become available every other level, but you don't need all of them to reach 60. Some of those are pricey and can wait until later or even never. There's no point in going broke for a new rank of a button you never use or a new button that you will never use. If you're not sure what's worth picking, there's lots of guides that highlight the essential skills for leveling. I know WoWhead has some. Train the good stuff and skip everything else. Speaking of skipping skill ups, tip 5 is don't train any crafting professions unless you really know what you're doing. It's a lot of gold not only in materials, but even just training new recipes to level them. The payoffs are possible, but risky. It's much safer while leveling to just take 2 gathering professions, sell everything, and worry about crafting later. Tip 6, for double gathering professions, consider skinning. You can certainly do mining and herbalism, but you can only track one of those at a time on your map. So one of those and then skinning can be a little more efficient unless you've just got an eye for spotting nodes. If you take skinning, consider leveling in areas with lots of beasts and keep an eye out for players that leave behind trails of bodies. I'm not saying follow them, but you know, someone's gonna. Tip 7, consider leveling fishing. There's a few fish in particular that should be in demand. Stone scale eels are used in endgame flasks, so those are a good one. You can get those from pools near Gadgetzan in Tanaris. Oily blackmouth are also used in alchemy, and you can find those around Darkshore, also the wetlands. And deviant fish are just fun, and those are found in the barrens near the Wailing Caverns. Tip 8, get an auction house add-on. I don't care which one, but you need something. The default UI makes it awful to try and see what the cheapest buyouts are, which is gross for both selling and buying. There's a few auction house add-ons around, but here's what I'm using right now. So, Auction Faster is a Classic specific auction add-on, and I've actually been using this over both Trade Skill Master and Auctioneer. Especially while leveling, you're probably just trying to sell something quickly and less worried about scanning the entire planet for a map of the economic landscape. Auction Faster makes it very easy to sell things for their going price and buying the cheapest version of whatever you're shopping for. I will say that it has been slightly wonky for me recently, mine may need an update, but on the whole, this is the experience that I prefer for Classic right now. Tip 9, focus on the rep for the mount you want. You'll get reputation discounts on your mount purchases. So if you're exalted, you could pay 64 gold rather than 80 for your first mount. For the epic one, you're looking at 800 rather than 1000. It's a big deal. If the mount that you have your eye on is not your racial mount, you'll need to be exalted anyways just to train the riding skill. So focus as much as you can on just the one rep. Even if you are planning on buying your racial mount, rep will still get you a discount. So this advice applies. Faction rep comes largely from questing, so I recommend pick just one faction and then hunt down the quests from them. Do keep in mind that Warlocks and Paladins do not need to buy their level 40 mount, so if you're playing one of those, don't stress so much. Also, if you ask me, half the fun in Classic comes from following your heart, so if you feel like you want to train every skill and level professions and be broke as a bucket, you do you. So those are the basics of Classic Gold. If you've got any great tips that I missed, feel free to share them down in the comments. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful, wonderful day. Bye!